Power. You can't fight off what you aren't even aware of. don't know until you know. And once you learn, you must perform daily. Behold, I give unto you power to tread upon serpents and scorpions, and nothing shall by any means hurt you.
Okay?
I said I'll wait.
I can't do that. See, I thought you were a Christian, a deacon. You can't help nobody out. I said I'll wait. You see, people like you, you won't learn until you learn. No, right now you may be, but later you'll see. I said I'd give him a year, but him, he had it coming. The root man, I bet you doesn't know who that is. It's my great-grandfather. He taught me everything I know, and now that I've been working my spells and my curses, or whatever you want to call it, I know some of us think it's not real. Halloween. But I dare you. I dare you tear me with someone who dabbles in this. First, the curse will start off slow. He'll become randomly annoying, seeing bugs out of nowhere. And then, he'll gain anxiety and lose all hope. And then after losing all hope, he'll lose everything. Icky. Just kidding. Just a simple. And it's done.
Blank, please talk to me. For the past few weeks, you've been sitting here irritable, not anything, see me in the room daily. At first I thought it was me, maybe I was doing something wrong in our marriage, so I gave you space. Blake, please talk to me.
I don't know what's going on, Wendy. I just need time. Just give me some time! Come on, babe, does it hurt?
Hey, Mom.
Oh, I have to check on you.
Hey, Mom. Put your hands on my mama one more time. Zore, no. He shouldn't even be up here, and stop letting him do that to you.
Get this child. Tell her to stop meddling in grown people's affairs. Tell her to go read a book or something, or anything to get her out of my face.
What?
You mad at grandpa for this thing separating you, but look what you're doing to me.
Sit your mind down! Man, she'll be alright. All kids do this when their parents start dating someone new. She needs to be grateful. It's not like her father's
in her life. Just please stop mentioning her. I will talk to her. But she's right, David. You have to stop hitting me like that. There's other ways that you can express yourself. You can yell at the top of your lungs. I would rather that than you touching on me.
Man, come on. You know you like when I touch on you.
No. Promise me this. Promise me that you'll never lay your hands on me again.
I promise.
David, you have to mean it this time.
Who is Blake Hill? A Christian, a deacon, and now a loser. What will you Christians understand this? It simply isn't enough to just go to church. You gotta guard your hearts, cover yourselves in prayer, protect your peace, walk daily, stop playing stupid, or we'll treat you like you are. You've been warned.
We should have known he recovered.
Yes, to see a man with such skill and knowledge plumbing is such a hard pill to swallow.
You heard it first. Well-known geography specialist and public speaker Blake Hills has just lost his job at the University of South Georgia.
There's also been talk that his house is up for foreclosure and his car has been repoed. Such a sad story.
Now, let's get into this weather.
Yes.
This is sick!
This is out of pocket!
Mom, you mean to tell me that y'all have not been paying the bills or the car note?
I've never touched a bill. That has always been your father's job, and that was his choice.
But Mom, you know Daddy has not been in his right frame of mind. What makes you think that he's paying any bills?
He's a 40-year-old man, that's what. Now look, we all need to calm down, think things through. I will talk to the guys so we can get the house issue settled. Yes, your father's car has been taken away. We can easily get that back as well.
This is crazy! Oh, this is great. I found a move, it's all good.
So you mean to tell me while all this is going on, you've been sitting around doing nothing?
I've been fending for my family and I've been strong.
You don't even take him to his counseling sessions. He needs help. What part of that don't you understand?
Exactly what have you been doing, Delilah, that needs help? Other than running around house, running around behind a deadbeat who doesn't have your best heart and interest.
Who dead?
Excuse me?
I'm yes, dead. Right? I'm sitting here, and you guys are acting as if I'm not. I can hear everything you've said.
Well, duh, my man. I mean, we know you're sitting here, and we know you're not crazy, but
we also
know you ain't
deaf. Everybody get out of my house.
No, like that's not right. We all are here for you.
Daddy, you can't just kick us out. Look how we've been living. This is crazy. We're just here to help you.
You're right. You're all right. I don't know what's been going on. You know what? No. Get out! Daddy. All of you get out of my house. Now! Daddy. I just need time! Something just don't feel like it.
blood of Jesus.
Just
I will not go see him, and I cannot see him like that. I've lost my husband, and I think that it's time that I file for a divorce. I've lost my husband. Thank God I didn't lose my home. I lost a lot, but by the grace of God, he carried me through it all.
About Lakeville, he signed in today.
How does he still have a wife and child? They're living lavish, and yet he signs into a home shelter. Something ain't right.
They say he lost his mind. I just can't believe it.
Well, guys, let's not try to make it awkward for him.
I agree.
Isabelle, what's going on now? You got something else. Come on, let's go to your room.
There he is.
Ah, oh, Blake Hill. It's an apology to finally meet you. May you please help me see that brother, sick? Marie, would you mind introducing yourself?
Hi, my name is Marie. This is Cynthia, and this is Carmen.
Hi, this is my daughter.
It's not much to tell you. Every day we have visitations, and ironically, we are allowed to have visitations.
So, like, is this a prison or a shelter?
I thought just like you when we first came here. But this is really a nice place. It doesn't feel like a shelter. It feels like home.
A home, Mom? This doesn't feel like a home at all.
Some kind of home.
Hi, I'm the new volunteer. I was told to be Kurt, I guess that's you.
Oh, yes. Are you here to volunteer for community service, your job, church?
Church? No, just out of the kindness of my heart.
Okay, that's good.
Professor, hi, how are you?
Hello, how are you?
Is this a class project or something? Are you involved in the class project?
I'm not.
This isn't a class project or anything of that sort. It's good seeing you again. I'm sure you're aware of my reasons for being here.
Aware? Why would I be aware?
The news. They plaster my name and my issues all over it, every day.
Oh, I don't watch that. Well, it's good seeing you again, and I hope that you overcome whatever you were putting
in.
Thank you. God. What? God, I don't even know what's going on right now. Show me the way. Guide me. Get me out of this. I don't even feel like I have control of my own self. My wife. I miss my wife. My family. God, I miss my family. My life. I miss that too. Lord, please help me, God. Get me out of this.
You'll be yours, Emorie.
you doing, bro? Man, you would not believe this.
I probably would.
I done violated probation again.
Stupid.
Now I got to volunteer at some little homeless shelter.
That's your fault.
Damn.
I can't make
yourself. I can't, man. Hey, I'm trying to jump you, brother.
Has anyone seen Zora? She said she's gonna take the bus home and she's not here.
Man, ain't nobody seen that loudmouth, disrespectful brat around.
David, this is serious. And you need to keep your mouth off my daughter.
Anyways, you know what Emorie is saying again? Anyways, I was...
Get up, get your things, and get out of this house now.
Milton, look at her. She's starting to get some bad balls. Now listen here, this is how this is gonna go. You're gonna step out my face, go and make me and my man's Milton something to eat in that kitchen, think about every dumb little thing you just said, and maybe a little brat will return by the end.
Well, I want you to relax your little self and let me tell you how this is gonna go. You gonna sit down and get up out my face, walk through that kitchen and smell what I've been cooking. Think about every dumb thing you just did. And then hopefully, you'll understand that me and you are done for good. Now, I need this done in 5.
Bro. She counted. Let's go, man. Let's go, man. Perfect. I'm gonna get on these devils.
Hold it.
Would you believe me if I told you things are just getting started? Humans take us for a joke because we're out of sight, out of mind, but we're always creeping in the shadows, waiting to see who we can devour. There just might be an evil spirit sitting beside you. Don't be afraid. Look, take us seriously. We're real, and we don't only show up on Halloween. Sometimes we grace your presence in your churches, on your jobs, in your homes, and in your minds. Are you listening? Do you hear me? Because after today, you're responsible.
I feel so bad. I remember that day in class when we talked about success. Professor, you lost your job. You lost your family. But you know what? You didn't lose your dignity. I know that you know deep down you're still an amazing and smart man. Professor, only you can truly heal yourself. I mean, we all want this for you, but we can't pick you up and dust you off or try to see it or determination inside your head. That's not you. Are you getting sick?
Visiting hours are over.
Oh, okay. I didn't get your name.
That's because I just wrote it. Like, get up and go to your room and do something with yourself.
That's not really nice.
The world isn't nice, honey.
I'll see you later.
People like him digging a ditch for himself. He pities himself.
You know what? I don't agree with that, and I need to speak with your supervisor.
I don't work here.
Well, good. That makes it easier for them to tell you to get out.
Little girl, stop right there! You better be careful how you talk to people, because you never know who you're talking to.
Wow! What is that? And weren't you in my geography class?
What is what and was?
On your ear. You're part of that club on campus. That magic arts club, huh?
Girl, back up. I don't follow nothing.
Now, we all go through a phase where we feel like we shouldn't be. I know a lot of times people feel like, because I'm a pastor, I've always been this perfect person or something, but couldn't be further from the truth. I used to have a horrible drinking problem. I know. By looking at me, you wouldn't be able to tell, right? Well, I want each of you to look at yourselves and see. You may be in a place right now that feels uncomfortable, but you'll be able to look back and tell God you understand why this had to happen. Now let's go around the room and let me hear from each one of you.
Well, I don't have much to say. Honestly, I'm content with being here.
That's not right, Mom. We hear all the time that you cannot get comfortable in your struggle.
That's right. Cynthia, this is a place to get people back on their feet, but once you get back on your feet, you gotta leave. This wasn't a place built for people to be perfect.
I get that. I do.
Okay.
Little girl. Little girl.
Is everything all right?
Everything's fine. This one right here, what's the joint?
Dust. Oh, well, of course. Yes, it ain't up to me.
It's okay. Only for today, though. You come here a lot to see Blake, so we can give you this pass.
Hey, just this one, Stella. But don't go around telling everybody because they never are going to have come in here. You sit down and listen. I'll let Pastor Wyatt finish his services. Go ahead, sit.
Thank you. Do I have to stay here for this?
Please stay. You just going around telling all these stories about ourselves.
You want me to stay?
Well,
y'all slide down.
This is
a
As I was saying, we're just going around telling uplifting stories about ourselves. For example, I told her I was addicted to alcohol, and then I was saved and delivered from it. Now you ain't got to go deep or tell us anything you don't want us to know. No, that's what the enemy wants. As soon as she's vulnerable enough to reveal her scars so they can be healed, it'd be absolutely unnecessary for us to escort her out now. Just give her a minute. Give her a minute.
This place is infested with bugs! Ever since I got here!
God! Emile, see, you're funny. Are you okay?
Oh, yeah, I'm perfect.
There's no bugs in this lake.
Yes, y'all.
He always talking about seeing bugs. Bugs, bugs, bugs.
Maybe y'all should split.
David meant everything to me. We were in high school and I thought he was the one and everything was perfect until after we graduated and I wanted to further my education and he wanted to stay home and do music. And he felt like I didn't support him enough. He started hitting me and coming over unannounced, thinking someone else was there, and I tried to break things off with him.
She's never spoken this much.
I told him that we couldn't be together anymore because we were on two different wavelengths. I had my own job. I was going to school. I had my own place. I was doing so well. And he still stayed at home with his mom, and I had never even met his mom. After all of that, he didn't even have a job other than his failed music career. And all he wanted to do was hang on the corner.
Okay.
After we broke up, he'd leave me crazy voicemails telling me he was going to kill me if I didn't get back together with him. And he was going to tell his mom to put a curse on me. That stuff isn't even real! I think it's all in my head. After that, everything went downhill for me. I stopped going to work. I stopped doing work. I stopped hanging out with my friends. It was like I didn't even have a conscience. It was like I wasn't even in control of my own self.
Listen, witches and warlocks are indeed real. You have to cover yourself in the blood every single day.
That young man was trouble from the start. I should have known him. And my daughter. My daughter!
Your daughter's with him?
I'm not even sure.
Someone has to help her, especially if she isn't.
Let us pray.
Excuse me, I got to.
Give me 2 minutes. 2 minutes.
Don't come on out.
Say it. Dear Lord.
You Christians! You're so naive, you know nothing. You're praying to a God who only wants to see you suffer.
No,
Blake, Isabelle, I'm the one that got you.
I knew it!
It was so easy to see whose spirit was weak. Isabelle, your single mother raised you. Took you to church every Sunday. Taught you about the Most High God. But you lost faith in him. Your spirit grew weak, but your flesh, it gained strength, and it simply amazed me. So you made yourself an easy target. Blake, such a well-groomed man you are, such a scholar. A deacon in the church, a faithful and loving husband, yet you set aside time for geography. You set aside time for your loving wife and your children, your family, but you left God a 2-hour Sunday morning service. Yes. See, that's why it was so easy to get to you. You had no boundaries. You had no walls. An open door, and you allowed me to step right on in.
This isn't her speaking. There's a spirit dwelling within her.
Blake, it isn't color. Yes, sir. David, he's my son.
Your son, Jesus. Blood of Jesus. Satan, I refuse you and send you back to hell.
Ever happened to someone. I should have been more watchful.
Harriet, it's time.
Thank you. Things are going to work out, Professor. I'll be sure of it. So if I can move this chair.
Inside and out.
I want you to live your life for you. Don't you ever follow in my footsteps. I love you so much, Zore.
I love you too, Mom.
Zore, go upstairs.
Hey, let me in.
David, please leave me alone.
Delilah, you really outdone yourself this time.
David, we are done. I found somebody. Well, somebody found me. Well, my mom really hooked us up, but he loves me and he treats me good, David. We're done. Please.
You're not. I won't let you go.
David, why can't you be happy for me?
Happy for you?
Yes.
I'm not afraid to die.
abortions.
It's not who I am.
It's not who I am. Cynthia, Isabelle, and Blake, they all signed up today.
I'm proud of them. All.
So am I. And hey, your grandma, she was right.
You know what? She was. You know, she passed like a week ago. Mm-hmm. But I bet she was proud of us. Because we're okay.
We gonna be all right.
Indeed, we are.
What?
Behold, I give unto you power
to tread upon serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you.
When it's all over.
put on my robe, tell the story.